And I've joked to my wife, if one of our kids gets type 1 diabetes, I'd probably end up liking that one more.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dr. Jeremy Pettus, and I'm here to tell you what it's like to both be a patient living with type 1 diabetes and somebody who's also a physician treating people with type 1. Okay, which type of diabetes do you have and why? Well, I have type 1 diabetes, which is classically kind of like the juvenile form. So I got it when I was 15. So why? I don't know. You know, we don't know why people get it. I guess I was the lucky one in the family. Okay, what's it like to be a 15-year-old with diabetes in the 90s? First of all, there's no good time to get diabetes, you know, I would say. People get it when they're 1, when they're 4, they're 15, when they're 55. And every age has its issues, I'm guessing. But as a high schooler, kind of the classic, I just didn't want to be different. And, you know, having to test my blood sugar at school. And, you know, back then it was this big glob of blood and it would take a minute for it to give you your answer. Now I don't even do it anymore, but it's 5 seconds or less if you do. So that minute of like kind of testing my blood sugar underneath my desk in the middle of school, I didn't like, and getting low a lot and having to get sodas, having to excuse myself from sports and things like that. I remember going to a restaurant right after I was diagnosed and ordered actually pancakes. And the waiter brought syrup by, and my dad yelled across the whole restaurant, you know, like, we can't have regular syrup, my son has diabetes. And I'm like, oh God. So they had to get the special, like, you know, low sugar syrup for me. So I was just kind of like dealing with embarrassment already as an awkward 15-year-old, and then having this extra thing lumped on me just wasn't that fun. But like I said, I tried to just kind of take it and run with it and use some of these things to my advantage, which I also tell people to do. Whenever you can, use type 1 diabetes to your advantage. It used to be that you could get in the front of the line at Disneyland if you had diabetes, but they got rid of that policy. But you can get in free to national parks, for example. So there's some good things to get out of it, and you should take advantage of it. What's the first thing people say when they find out that you have diabetes? I think people do have a lot of questions, and I don't mind when people ask me anything. If they say, hey, you know, like, I don't really know that much about diabetes, to be honest. Tell me what it's like to X or whatever. Educate me. I'm fine with that. What bothers me is when people tell me things. You know, they'll just come up to me at a party. They'll even know I'm a physician and say, oh, type 1 diabetes, you can't eat candy, right? Or did you know that there's a cure out there and they're just not telling you about it? That stuff drives me crazy. So ask me all the questions you want. Just don't tell me anything, because chances are I know more. Not because I'm a doctor, just because I've been living with it for so long. Do you worry about your boys getting type 1 diabetes? So I have a 4-year-old and a 1-year-old boy. And yes, I worry about it. This is where I can rely on my education and training as a doctor and realizing that there's only about a 5% chance that, you know, your kids, if you have type 1s, will get it. So if I have type 1, there's a 5% chance that they'll get it, meaning there's a 95% chance that they won't get it. But I think the hardest thing about it is it's just something that I don't want to feel like I've given to my son, because that would be devastating. I'm going to move on from that one. How has having diabetes affected your parenting? And I've joked to my wife, if one of our kids gets type 1 diabetes, I'd probably end up liking that one more, just because it's a way of like bonding with them and you have something so serious in common. What I will say about my diabetes and my home life is I try to do it all myself. And I maybe that's like the father, you know, masculine provider thing that you don't want to burden anybody else. I don't want anybody to know what my blood sugar is. I don't want suggestions on how to kind of fix things. I just want to take care of it and not have it affect myself, but not really have anybody else even be aware of it. And so if my wife and kids go through the day and they have no idea that anything I did was diabetes related, then, you know, that's a total win for me. So why do you work for UC San Diego Health? I think there's just a lot going on here. So, you know, I do research, I do clinical care. I'm somebody living with type 1 diabetes. Our clinical staff are excellent. You know, in the clinic that I work with, there's multiple other people that have type 1 diabetes. Not that that makes you awesome, but it definitely helps. The research I do is clinical research, so I'm seeing people and doing new therapies and things like that. So it really is this hybrid between the clinic and the research that I think is really fantastic. Is a cure for diabetes on the horizon? So basically, everyone's always been told 10 to 15 years. I have friends that were diagnosed in the 70s, and they said 10 to 15 years. 80s, 10 to 15 years. Obviously, we haven't had it in 10 to 15 years. I don't want to put a date on it for that reason. I will say that I don't know when the cure is going to be, but in the next 3 years, something very tangible and close, we will have completely automated insulin delivery systems that will deliver insulin based on your continuous glucose monitor without you having to do much of anything, counting carbs, you know, thinking less about exercise, things like that. So it's not a cure, still a pump, continuous glucose monitor, all this stuff you have to wear, but it's just gonna get a lot easier, you know, less for us to think about and better control. Do you wish you could take a vacation away from your diabetes? Absolutely. I mean, this is something about diabetes in general and type 1 is that it's every minute of every day. Literally, I can look right now and see what my blood sugar is. If it's high or low, I probably have to do something. I have thought about, though, what if there was a cure? How weird would it be to not have type 1 diabetes? Because it is such a big part of me. I think it would be strange to all of a sudden just kind of walk away from it. Don't get me wrong, I would love it. I'm trying to find this cure for me and everybody else out there. So yes, I want a vacation, but it's also part of me. All right. Okay, anything I would like to add? I would just say that, again, you know, when I was 15, I remember feeling really bummed out that I was diagnosed with this. And I didn't understand really then that this would really be something that I'd be living with potentially for the rest of my life. But now, sitting here where I am now, you know, I think that 15-year-old would be really proud